quickly reading some scripture. I felt like the Lord would have me to do this, and then we'll have the first song. You know, the Lord promised to send His Son long before He came.
Amen.
He promised that He would be the seed of the woman in Genesis chapter number 3. When He said, I will put enmity between thee and the woman, between thy seed and her seed, and shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. He was speaking to the serpent that was filled with the court with Satan and the woman Eve. He promised that He would be the seed of the woman. He promised He'd be the seed of Abraham. Genesis 18, seeing that Abraham shall surely become a great and mighty nation, and all the nations of the earth shall be blessed in him. It was a question, but it was a prophecy that he would be the seed of Abraham. He would be the seed of not only Abraham, but Isaac, a specific son of Abraham. In Genesis 17, God said, Sarah, thy wife, shall bear thee a son indeed. Thou shalt call his name Isaac, and I will establish my covenant with him for an everlasting covenant, and with his seed after him. The whole Islam race based their religion that Abraham's son of the handmaid Ishmael was the promised son, but that's not the promise that God gave to Abraham. He even called his son by name that he would bless through. He said, thou shalt call him Isaac. It was through his wife, not through his handmaid, but through his wife. So God is very specific about his promise that he would be the seed of a woman, be the seed of Abraham, be the seed of Isaac, and be the seed of Jacob. Another specific son of all of his sons. In Numbers 24:17, he said, I shall see him, but not now. I shall behold him, but not nigh. There shall come a star out of Jacob, and a scepter shall not, a scepter shall rise out of Israel, and shall smite the corners of Moab, and destroy all the children of Shem. He said he would descend from the tribe of Judah in Genesis 49. The scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor a lawgiver from between his feet until Shiloh come. That's the Lord, the Savior. And unto him shall the gathering of the people be. He would be heir to the throne of David, Isaiah 9:7. Of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end upon the throne of David. On the throne of David and upon his kingdom to order it, to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Thousands of years before, God is telling he's going to send his son. He told where he would, not only the family, but where he would send him, the place of his birth in Micah 5:2. But thou, Bethlehem Ephratah, though thou be little among the thousands of Judah, yet out of thee shall he come forth unto me, that is to be ruler in Israel. Little Bethlehem. God promised that. The time of his birth in Daniel 9:25. Know therefore and understand, God told him, that from the going forth of the commandment to restore and to build Jerusalem unto the Messiah the Prince shall be 7 weeks and 62 weeks. The street shall be built again and the wall, even in troublous times. The coming of the Lord, the coming of the Messiah, a specific time. He'd be born of a virgin, Isaiah 7:14. Therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel.
Amen.
So God promised that he would send his son, promised the time he would send his son, promised to whom he would send his son.
Amen.
And that he would be born of a virgin. That's what we're celebrating, that incarnation of Christ after thousands of years, after 4,000, to be precise, God sent his son into the world.
Mm-hmm.
2,000 years ago, and now we're waiting for the rest of his promises to be fulfilled.
Hey.
He fulfilled those. He's definitely going to fulfill the rest.
Amen.
His son is going to come. I want Michael and Chandis to come on. You know, they're going to sing a song. I hope it blesses your heart. As we're celebrating this time of the year, we have our families and friends. There are those that are not with us. There are those that have went on to heaven. Those that are not celebrating Christmas with us here anymore, but they're celebrating in heaven.
Hey.
And, you know, we should not forget, though, that so many times they sat in the living room and smiled, or they sat at the table and ate with us. And, you know, we've got grandpas and grandmas, brothers and sisters, aunts and uncles, cousins, husbands and wives, gone on. But if they are saved, we'll see them again one day.
Amen.
And thank God that we can celebrate that hope this time of year. Even though we miss them, we have that hope because of who we're celebrating.
Amen.
That's why we're celebrating Christmas. It's not the man in the red suit.
Right.
It's not about snow. And it's not about trees and lights. All those things are beautiful. I love trees and lights. And I love the snow. But it's not about all that.
No.
It's about Jesus.
That's right.
It's about right. God sending his son. So you pray for them as they sing this song. Okay.
You're not here to celebrate with me.
her heart, but God reminded me one day, and he said she was mine before she was ever yours. And she said she's with me.
So,
one day we'll be with you.
Child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not willing to make her a public example reminded, put her away previously. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto Mary their wife.
Amen.
For that which is conceived is her, is of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. For he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife, and knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn son. And he called his name Jesus.
Amen.
Luke 1, through 38. 26 to 38. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent to God into the city of Galilee, named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou art highly favored. The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus.
Amen.
He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David, and he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end.
Amen.
Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God.
Amen.
And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, she hath also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month with her, who was called barren. They said, Nothing shall be impossible, for with God nothing shall be impossible.
Amen.
And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word, with the angel. And the angel departed from her.
God is love.
Amen.
We just heard another correct reading of the salutation to
Joseph and Mary from the angel concerning the incarnation of Christ through that virgin. Even then, even Mary, she said, how shall this be? Seeing I know not a man, she just couldn't understand. Had never been with a man. God let her know she was the virgin. She was the virgin. That holy thing was in her.
Shepherds watch from heaven.
Bryant, would you come and share with us briefly?
Somebody may have a testimony while we get there.
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augusta that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one unto his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people.
Amen.
For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord.
Amen.
And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said unto one another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at these things which were told them by the shepherd. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, and it was told as it was told unto them.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus is the Word of God.
Amen.
Jesus is. place in those places.
Amen.
One night in Bethlehem.
Amen.
Hey.
Thank the Lord.
Hey.
We don't know exactly when that night was. It probably wasn't December 25th. It was probably in the middle of summer. The shepherds would have their sheep in the inn instead of out in the field. It's cold in Jerusalem. And far from the cold, I wandered in darkness alone.
Amen.
With no one to comfort my poor dying soul. So
Christ is the Lord.
22, I mean, verses 1 through 23. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him." When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all of Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, "In Bethlehem of Judea. For thus it is written by the prophet, 'And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah. For out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel.'" Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he went, and he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the young child. And when ye have found him, bring me word again that I may come and worship him also." When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to him, they departed into their own country another way. And when they were departed, behold, the angel of the Lord appeareth to Joseph in a dream, saying, "Arise, and take the young child and his mother, and flee unto Egypt, and be thou there until I bring thee word. For Herod will seek the young child to destroy him." When he arose, he took the young child and his mother by night, and departed into Egypt, and was there until the death of Herod, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, "Out of Egypt have I called my son." Then Herod, when he saw that he was mocked of the wise men, was exceeding wroth, and sent forth and slew all the children that were in Bethlehem, and all the coast thereof, from 2 years old and under, according to the time which he had diligently inquired of the wise men. Then was fulfilled that which was spoken by Jeremy the prophet, saying, "In Ramah there was a voice heard, lamentation and weeping and great mourning, Rachel weeping for her children, and would not be comforted because they are not. But when Herod was dead, behold, an angel of the Lord appeareth in a dream to Joseph in Egypt, saying, 'Arise, and take the young child and his mother, and go into the land of Israel, for they are dead which sought the young child's life.' And he arose and took the young child and his mother, and came into the land of Israel. But when he heard that Archelaus did reign in Judah in the room of his father Herod, he was afraid to go thither. Notwithstanding being warned of God in a dream, he turned aside in the parts of Galilee. And he came and dwelt in a city called Nazareth, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophets, 'He shall be called a Nazarene.'"
Amen.
Thank you. A card here that might give to joy to the world, and it's from one of our missionaries.